Hey guys, it's Kevin. This is part 3 of converting ET-8550 into a DTF printer. We already converted the printhead into a nipple printhead and installed it. In this video, we're going to remove the Starwheel, you already call it a pizza wheel, and install this printhead management assembly. Not only it can manage the pressure for your printing, but also it can handle the daily maintenance, which prevents clogging. Then I'll show you how to connect to the ink tank, which has the white ink management system incorporated. I will walk you through the daily printing maintenance, color configuration, and how to use the software. You're going to remove a screw on the left, and then you move your printer carriage to your right, and then remove another screw on the right. You'll see the star wheel is loose after this. Look, the star wheel is pushed down by some tension springs. So you just push the tension spring aside, deattach the tension spring, and you can remove the whole star wheel. So I just removed the spring on the right. Now I'm going to remove the tension spring on the left. And give a little jiggle and pay attention to where stops you from removing the star wheel, and then it'll come out. Word of caution is, if you do not install the head of your drag chain correctly, your drag chain might get a stop in the middle. See the drag chain get by this black plastic. Okay. You just need to push it in all the way and it'll work. Now we're going to install this printhead assembly, which you can see have two tanks and four outputs. The left two are the white ink secondary tank for the white ink, and the right tank is the maintenance tank, so it holds the maintenance fluid. Remember, we have 7 strands. The left two strands for the white ink and the maintenance, and the middle four colors. The bottom one is also for the white ink. We'll temporarily put the head of the drag chain there, and we're going to separate the tubes. The four colors going to go underneath the assembly. The white ink and the water, I'll call the water, the maintenance tube is going to be on the top. I'll put one screw here to stabilize it. And on the left, the screw hole is sandwiched between your drag chain head and the base. So basically, the screw on your left is going to go through two layers before it gets to the base. Now we're going to connect all the colors. Remember, your clear tube is a C2 tube, so you're going to use elbows to connect them to the damper. So we finish installing the color tubes. What about the other tubes? Let's look at the plan. So the first line is the water line, or we call the maintenance line. I'll use blue. So blue goes to the tank on the right, which in turn goes to two nipples on the right. So basically, I get the first tube and attach elbow and insert into the maintenance tank. Remember, we've done the color ink, which go underneath the assembly as I connect to four color dampers. Now let's talk about two white lines. The first white line is besides the water line, and it goes to the white circulation tank. Come out of the white circulation tank and get feedback with another line. The two nipples on the left is going to supply the white ink to the damper. This is called a direct-to-damper technology. So basically, your four colors are sandwiched between the two white lines. Now, the only thing we need is connect the two white nipples to the damper. The white tube is a C3 tube, so it just a tube goes into the connector, and you'll put the C3 tube on it. So the first white damper goes to the very left of the four nipples. The second white damper goes to the second nipple. Then when the custom tubes the same length as the tube goes into those white dampers, we install on the rest of two nipples, and those going to come from the maintenance tank. Those tubes are only used when we do the daily maintenance, so we're going to connect them and basically disable them. We can have an elbow connect them, or we can just put a piece of tube, and then we push them behind the tubes goes in the one damper. You just install the printed tank assembly. Now on the other end of the tube, we're going to connect to our ink tanks. There are six connectors, and you connect a white ink on the both sides and the four color inks in the middle. That makes six tubes. We have one tube extra with the seventh tube, and that's the maintenance tube. You're going to connect that tube to the seventh tube with elbow. Now we're going to fill up the tanks. The first tank on the right is the water tank or maintenance tank. Because I'm going to do daily maintenance, I'm just going to add distilled water in it. We add color inks and the white inks. We just finished the whole installation. Next video, we're going to configure the white ink system, and we're going to show you how to print. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at bchtechnologies.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers!